doesn't get back to the line.
And you love to see those linebackers playing downhill like that. Not just flowing sideline to sideline, but attacking and trying to get in the backfield.
Goes through his progression.
Into traffic, and it's picked off.
Has a man to his right. He breaks through. And he's tackled. Newton will hand it off. Tries to juke the defender, and he will be tackled.
Nothing makes a defensive coordinator cringe more than seeing that kind of run, because then it sets up the play action.
And they get to him.
Number one, taken down for a sack. Loss of six.
He'll be brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
You know, for a running back, there comes a point in time where you say, all right, this play is not working.
Makes the throw over the middle. Looking deep, and he's got a man open. And that play could have easily gone for six. Still looking for an open man. He's wrestled down at about the 25.
And it didn't look like the quarterback even saw him coming.
Yeah, he gets back there so fast that even if you have quick reaction time, you're still going to get sacked.
And the pass will fall incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
I don't know if that's the guy I want to pick on third down when you have to have a conversion. He is tough.
And he makes it. That'll make it second down with 10 to go. Looking for a man. Uh-oh, watch out. Spin move, and he's brought down.
And so far in this one, as you can see, this player has been...
Big gain through the air.
Yeah, and you see the defensive back try to make a play on the ball there instead of making sure the pass fell incomplete. This guy will make a lot of big plays for his team, but sometimes it's a bit of a gamble, and that time it didn't pay off.
We'll see if he takes a more conservative approach the next time the ball is thrown.
27-yard line. Looking for a big gain down the middle. He's brought down right around the 11-yard line. They hand it off. Dropped behind the line.
Did you see how fast that linebacker was on that one? Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
Here we go. Flex round. Flex round. Ohio.
Going down the middle with it. Throws it into coverage. Easily intercepted.
Yeah, I just don't think he saw the coverage right on that one. There's no way you try and force that one in. Bringing up a third down situation. Either you keep the drive alive here or the defense turns it over to the offense.
And the tackle was made by Charles Woodson. Goes through his progression. Deep pass. He wants the end zone. Picked off in the end zone.
Are you kidding me? You cannot throw that ball in this situation with the game on the line. That's terrible.
Grant on the give. He's dropped down. The offense needs about 3 yards to get the first here on third down. He gets another carry. He's loose and running strong.
Okay, if they want to throw the ball, take a chance on getting a big play, that's fine. But to see a run go for that kind of a gainer, that makes you sick.
That should all but seal this one up.
And that's what you want to try and do as an offense. Put the dagger right in their heart. Don't give them the football back. Maintain possession and put them away with a big score. What a great drive. If you want to, time to pad the stats a little bit now. A couple of cheap completions. Go home, tell mommy you had a great game.
Has a man out to his right. Intercepted, and that should be it. To the 20. Is he going to score? Touchdown, Packers.
And just like that, they make it a two-possession game.
What a tremendous return that was. And even better, now you have a little breathing room when you look up at that scoreboard.
That should wrap things up here, Chris.
Yep, not a lot of time left now. This one's pretty much over.
The PAT is up and good.
Yards to go.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
Still looking for an open man.
Tucks and runs. He's free. Picks up the ball and he can run.
Well, you get...
I'm a New Orleans nigga. I don't take no shit. Take the brain off the whip. Now it don't make no sense. Stunt hard on these bitches. I ain't promised tomorrow.
That's all from Bank of America Stadium. Our post-game wrap-up is next. And let's take a look at Gatorade, performer of the game.
Man, I'm too much for these niggas and too much for these hoes. The world is in my hands.